Hi, I'm Jaxton. I'm a visual artist. I'm also an independent curator and art educator. So I've been doing this for 6-7 years. So at the start, I'm just doing works that are more commercial because I'm painting, and then I consign my works to a gallery. Yeah, in hope to sell them. After I did my master's in the Glasgow School of Art in UK, I realized that's not something I want to do. I want to be more experimental and really create works that I can resonate with. I also started to experiment with found objects. That also got me interested in the materiality of different mediums and objects. So found objects, like for example a sea sponge or like metal pieces, glass pieces that I found on the streets, just anything. So actually contemporary art offers so much more possibilities to art making. So PowerPlay started off as a collaboration between me and Ishwa Imran. Ishwa came up with this idea about power and then this title PowerPlay. So I thought it's quite an interesting topic to explore, especially in Singapore, because Singapore because of censorship, a lot of times the issues that are explored in artwork in Singapore is quite reserved and quite safe. To be honest, we didn't have that experience yet in producing such a big event involving international artists and a big group of artists, and we were quite ambitious because we wanted to rope in 40 artists in total. So it took a while. So it took 2 years to realize it. So now it's at its stage of realization. Unfortunately, it cannot be physical. We wanted it to be physical, but because of COVID, our venue partner, Arts House, couldn't open to the public yet. So we have to make it a digital event with just media preview. Because of circuit breaker, it's my work has been quite impacted because a lot of projects are postponed indefinitely or cancelled. Most of my income comes from mural painting projects and community art projects. So community art projects can't happen because we can't gather in crowds. So that's one thing that's off. And then mural painting, because it's something that it's not an essential. So and also circuit breaker, we are stuck at home. There's nothing much we could do except like maybe occasional online workshops or try to plan for when the circuit breaker is over. So during that first half of the year, it was quite tough. But after that, it suddenly everything just snowballed and started to happen again. So from I think June or July onwards, it's really projects after projects, and it was quite busy. So I guess it's picking up well and catching up well. So I'm hopeful. To be honest, I'm looking forward to a break because it's been really tiring and non-stop, because I previously was the two-part exhibition at Substation and Ziji. Then after that, it was the project at DEC. And then immediately after, it's PowerPlay. So it has been really tiring. And on top of that, I'm also doing other projects as an artist, like mural painting projects. And also I teach part-time at NTU. So these are all keeping me really occupied at the moment. So I'm actually yearning for a break. I guess Singapore is still at its initial stage for the arts. Yeah, especially in contemporary art. I guess there really needs more to be done, and then boundaries need to be pushed, and there needs to be more support for the arts. Future, it's a bit unsure at the moment because there are a lot of, because of COVID as well, there are a lot of spaces that are closing down, and it's like NAC is taking back a lot of spaces, art spaces, and I guess we just have to be hopeful.